Hello and welcome to this painting video. In this video, we're going to show how to paint a Chaos Cultist in a Nurgle theme. Now, we're mainly using contrast paints and we'll paint the model up to battle ready as well. But before we do that, we need to undercoat the model. And as you can see here, I've used white scar, which is perfect for the colours we're going to be using. Now, we're going to start first on the skin. We'll be using Mortarian Grime. And we'll be coating this a couple of times just to add a bit of depth to that green Nurgly skin. After that, we're going to be using Gut Ripper Flesh for the green cloth. For the black leathers, we'll be using Black Legion, and then for the white trousers, we're going to be using Soulblight Grey. But first of all, let's start with that skin. So I'm just going to dip this straight into the pot, just load up my brush a little bit, make sure I've got a decent point to it still, so I'm quite happy with that. And all we then do is then start applying that to the skin. I might have to go back in there again and get a bit more on there, that's better. As this is a shade, it's going to flow into all those recesses and just slightly pull away from the actual raised areas, which is why we're going to add a second coat, just add a little bit more depth to some of those raised details as well. Just take your time, and if you do find it heavily pooling in the recesses, just soak up any excess with your brush. With a second coat of Mortarian Grime now applied, you can see it's just add a bit more depth to that musculature. So what we're now going to do is move on to using Gut Ripper Flesh for the green cloth. Again, take your time, and if you do find it heavily pooling at the bottom, just use your brush to soak up any excess. Now that we've done the green cloth, what we're now going to do is move on to the black leather. So what I'm going to do is just start coating all over using Black Legion. You can take your time. If you make any mistakes, you can always tidy back up with a little bit of white scar. Now that we've picked out all that black leather, what we're going to do is get some Soulblight Grey and apply that to the trousers just to make dirty white trousers. With that dirty white cloth now done, we're going to move on to applying some more colours. We're going to start first with Iron Hand Steel for all the metallic areas. Then we're going to get Targor Raid Shade, coat that over the metals, as well as the green cloth. Then we're going to get Garagax Sewer to add a bit of rust to that metal. Then finish off on the scars and any wounds using Berserker Bloodshade. But first of all, let's start by picking out those metals. So I'm just going to get a little bit on palette. As it's a base paint, I'm just going to thin it down a little bit so it's not too thick and goopy. And get a good point to my brush. And then we're ready to start picking them out. So I'm just going to start on the actual gun and work my way around. Now that we've done all the metal areas, what we're now going to do is coat over those metals using Targor Raid Shade. And we're also going to apply that over his green cloth. This is a really nice colour because it gives it a bit more of a reddy brown kind of tone. Makes it look a little bit rusty. Now that we've applied Targor Raid Shade to all those metallics and also the green cloth, what we're now going to do is get Garagax Sewer and apply it to parts of the weapons and a few little bits on the armour here and there. This is going to add a bit more depth and a bit more oranginess to that rust effect we're aiming for. Now that we've applied a rust here and there, especially to the weapons, we're going to get Berserker Bloodshade and just start adding that around areas that got scars. So you've got a nice deep cut here, so I'm just going to drop that in there, stab a little bit more. And he's got this whole bionic around his chest. I'm just going to start actually just running that round so it's like an old seeping wound. And take your time, work your way around. With those wounds and scars now picked out of Berserker Bloodshade, what we're now going to do is move on to basing the model. We're going to start first by using Sterling Mud and apply that all over. Once that's dry, we're going to get Targor Raid Shade just to add a bit of depth. But first of all, let's get some Sterling Mud. So I'm just going to use the large side of the scoop, like so, get some of that on the base, and then all I'm going to do is then just plop that on because it's nice and muddy, really adds to that Nurgle theme. I'm just going to drop a little bit at the back there just to get rid of some of that excess. And what I'll do is move to the smaller scoop side, like so, for a bit more accuracy, especially around those feet. Once that's all applied on, you want to leave it for around about an hour to dry before we apply our shade. Now that the texture's fully dry, we're just gonna get Targor Raid Shade and just apply that over. That's just gonna give it a little bit more depth, but still maintaining that nice brown tone. And there we are, the rim now painted, our base is now done. With the texture now dry and the rim of the base painted, our Nurgle themed Chaos Cultist is now battle ready and eager to spread decay and pestilence across the galaxy. Now, there's a couple of things to remember when painting this model. Firstly, when using shades or contrast, try not to overload your brush as it can quickly run out of control. If you do find that happening, dry off your brush and just soak off any excess. Also, like in this video, if you use any metallics, once you're done with that, just change your water. You don't want any of those metallic flecks mixing in with your contrast and shades. Well, I hope you've enjoyed this video. Hope you enjoy painting your own battle-ready Chaos Cultists, and we'll see you again soon. Bye-bye.